Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Actually, welcome to my channel because this is my very first podcast ever. I've never done this before, so I'm sorry if it's not as good as you expected. I have been going through YouTube looking up how to run a successful podcast, and I promise I'm trying my best. But enough about me. How are you doing? How's your day going? And if it's just starting, how was your night? In case you don't know this yet, I'm Praise and you're tuned in to Creepy Pastor with Praise. So yeah, before we get into our outline for today, I just wanted to let you know that I'd really appreciate it if you could stop by at my other socials and give them a follow, you know, subscribe if needed, and just show some support. Thanks. Right now we can progress. So I'm basically all about creepy, nostalgic, and you know, horrific, all the eerie and scary stuff that surround the world, both true and, you know, story and whatnot. And yeah, I didn't see anything better to launch my podcast with than one of the world's creepiest animations ever. And yes, I'm talking about 2009's Coraline. I'm sure like a lot of you have already seen it, or you've read the book or the graphic novel, but I'm going to brief you on it anyways for those of you who for some reason haven't heard about it or seen it. So the movie starts when a family, the Jones, move from Michigan to Pink Palace apartment in Oregon. The beginning scene portrays her parents, Mel and Charlie, as workaholics, the kind that don't usually have time for Coraline. So Coraline, being bored, decides to explore the house when she finds a little door. Her mom opens it after Coraline had bugged her, only to reveal bricks, like there was nothing behind the door, just as if it was just a wall and someone just fixed the door in front of the wall and just put wallpaper over it. So, you know, her mom forgets to lock it and she just walks away because she's busy, she's working on Coraline, it's disturbing her, you get that. So Coraline goes out in search of a well, claims she's a water fairy, when she discovers she's being followed by a guy, his name is Wyburn. And his cat, or like a stray cat that always moves around with him. They chat a little, but not like your friendly kind of chat. Coraline sees Wyburn as annoying and doesn't really want much to do with him, although he later on leaves a rag doll he claimed he had found in his grandmother's trunk that looks so much like Coraline. Later that night, she is led by a mice through the little door that now leads to another version of her house, where she meets her other mother and her other father. They are obviously the complete opposite of her real parents. They cook real food, pay attention to her, love to in this dimension can talk. She finds out that just like her, he can also travel through the universe, making a perfect explanation as to why his eyes are not button. And yes, every single person in the other world except Coraline and the cat have buttons for eyes. So yeah, one night during dinner, the other mother tells Coraline that she can stay in the other world with them forever on the condition that she also gets buttons for eyes. Terrified, she runs to bed, hoping to wake up in the real world, but she doesn't, obviously. Angered, Coraline goes to meet her other mother and tells her she wants to go back home to her real mom. And the other mom doesn't like that idea. She gets angry. She starts saying all sorts of things like, you can't talk to your mom like that, apologize immediately. And, you know, she pushes her into a mirror saying she won't be out until she learns to behave or something of that nature. There she meets three ghosts. previous children also tricked by the other mother, of whom is YB's, one of whom is YB's great aunt. She tells Coraline that the other mother is actually Beldon, and she uses the doll Coraline hired to spy on the kid, although it would look like the kid in question instead of Coraline, obviously. She usually looks at how unhappy the kids are and creates a whole universe where things are the way they would love it, and you know, all that. They also told her how Beldon traps their souls and hides them once they agree to get buttons for eyes. She promises to free their souls for a few minutes before YB frees her and helps her to the new world. On getting home, she discovers her parents have been taken by Beldon, and she goes to meet the actresses who give her something. I don't know what it's called, but when I googled it, they said it's called an Aether Stone. Sorry if my pronunciation is terrible. Later that night, she goes back to the other world with the cat and challenges the other mother. She says if she finds the ghost souls and her parents, then they would all be free to go, else she can sew buttons on her eyes and she will stay with her forever. So yes, to cut the long story short, Coraline finds the souls with the aid of the stone from the actresses and the cat, only to encounter Beldon again, this time in her true form. Coraline tricks the other mom to open the little door and throws the cat at her. He pulls out her button eye, she turns the room into a web. Coraline finally escapes and locks the door behind her, cutting one of Beldon's wrists off. Coraline's parents return with zero knowledge of what had happened, and she is warned in a dream by the ghost children that Beldon would return in search of the key, so she decides to throw it down the well she saw earlier. She gets attacked by Beldon's wrist, you know, the one she cut off, and luckily the cat contacts YB, the real YB this time. He helps her and they throw the wrist down the well and the key, and they live happily ever after. At least that's what I was supposed to think. So yeah, I'll leave a link in the description in case you want to watch the movie again or you want to watch it for the first time. Another reason is I just leave it. I'll link you to a place where you can see it on YouTube. Yeah, now let's move into things that you may have missed from the movie. So yeah, almost no one watches a movie in search of hidden details, and that's the truth. Yeah, some people are gifted with sensitive and sharp eyes, while others make a living from spotting, you know, this kind of stuff out. But that's about it. And it's okay if you are just watching a movie for fun, you know, because it's a movie, not a documentary. You're not watching it for school, you're watching it for your entertainment. But in case you're still interested in finding out all the things you may have missed from Coraline, keep listening. And yeah, for those of you who haven't followed me or subscribed, please do that now. I would really appreciate it. It doesn't cost anything. So yeah, thank you. Now I won't take this accordingly, so I may start from the beginning of the movie and jump to the end and come all the way back to the beginning. It all depends. Aside from the obvious warnings Coraline got throughout the movie and common sense, of course, which she obviously lacked for some reasons, there were many other hidden warnings, even in the other world, although most of them couldn't really say it directly since they were all under Beldon's control. But the first things I want to make mention to has nothing to do with Coraline directly. The first one is the Raft Brothers moving truck at the beginning of the movie. This is also kind of like shout out to the animators Jerome and Joe. Yeah, next we have the face on the dollar bill giving us tips to one of the movers. They had replaced Washington's face with that of Selig, the director. Don't know if I say that well either. Next is the song the other father sang to Coraline when they first met. Remember when she went to call him out for dinner? So yeah, I can't sing it because of copyright and all that, but I'll just read out the lyrics for you and allow you to be creative. Just, you know, try and guess what the message behind the song is. Many people interpret it in different ways. You can see different interpretations on YouTube. Well, in case you're interested in my interpretation of the song, I would link it below so you can check it out. Anyways, here is the lyrics. Okay. So it's making up a song about Coraline. She's a peach, she's a doll, she's a pal of mine. She's as cute as a button in the eyes of everyone who laid their eyes on Coraline. When she comes around exploring, Mom and I will never make it boring. Our eyes will be on Coraline. So yeah, creepy much. But the next one is not, I'm not 100% sure of this yet, but there's a conspiracy out her other mother, Mel, her real mother, Mel, and the reason why she has a neck collar on. Many people relate to the fact that she could have like tried to get insurance money, but instead it didn't go down as planned. So now she's not only hurt, but they're also bankrupt for some reason, which is why they had to move to Oregon and why she's always grumpy. And I don't know, but I'm mistaken for some reason, but like, isn't Oregon where Sanders was like plotted around? Yeah, I don't know, please comment below. Maybe I'm right, maybe I'm wrong. So yeah, another conspiracy around this movie is the fact that Coraline's real parents are actually dead, and the people who appeared after she supposedly saved them from boredom was, you know, her other parents. And yeah, most people say the other mom is actually acting, so Coraline won't have a reason to leave. And yes, you may be asking, do I think this is a possibility? Yes, actually, because Beldon has the ability to shapeshift herself and others into things, including changing their button eyes. If you go back to the scene when Coraline had found the souls and was trying to like trick Beldon, you notice that at some point her eyes were like normal and not button, and it couldn't probably be a mistake. I don't know. But yeah, so that's something to think on. Then going back to the beginning of the movie, when Coraline had dinner with her other family, if you looked at the wall behind her, you would have noticed these silhouette pictures of the three souls framed. That's easy to miss, since no one actually knows about them at that point of the movie, unless maybe someone told you about it, or you have read about it, you've read the book, or you've watched the movie already. But if you go back again, you see that there are three souls representing all those three ghost children she met when she was locked in the mirror. Okay, then this is a little off, but around the beginning of the movie, when Coraline was searching for the well, you may have noticed she stepped in the middle of some sort of plant on the ground that was in form of a perfect circle. I'll do a whole podcast on this, but it's called a fairy ring, and it's believed to bring bad luck if you step into one. There's a girl, Fangirl, she's on YouTube. She says it could be why all those bad things happened to Coraline throughout the movie. Finally, when Coraline went to visit the actresses and they tried reading her future, her fortune, I don't know, from the cup, you may have noticed the sediments from Beldon's clawed hands when, you know, you turned it around, unless you were turning it in the other way, which will look like a giraffe or so they claim. But it looked like the sediments of the tea from the claws of Beldon's hand. Yeah, most people miss that, I don't know. So yeah, that's basically all for now. Please leave a comment below if you disagree with anything I said, or if you feel I left out anything. Also, let me know what you want me to cover next time. I'll link my socials below so you can check it out if you wish. I'd really appreciate. And yeah, do have a nice day, and I hope to see you here next time. Bye.